Very good morning, everybody. It is our daily webinar time here at the Hispanic Response and Recovery Plan on the Hispanic Star campaign. Every day we bring you webinars with incredible leaders to share information, education, and tools that can help us grow and survive in this time of the pandemic. This is part of what we're doing in this clearinghouse for information and action, bringing you tools, resources. And I just want to give us everybody a reminder at HispanicStar.org. We have a directory of resources to make sure that we can bring all the resources that Hispanics need in this time, from health, mental health, education tools to have with your kids working from home, to the best tips about personal practices, corporate practices, how to get credits. All of that is at the HispanicStar.org in the directory of resources. And something new that we just launched is the marketplace. The marketplace for those who have and those who need. Marketplace for talent and services. In this time, there are many people that are trying to hire and there are many people that are trying to get a job. In this time, there's a lot of people that want to donate something and people that need to get something. So that marketplace is for us an opportunity to do that matchmaking between those that have and those have need, particularly for talent and services. And that is very, very important for all of us. We've been helping a number of companies that want to donate food, for example, and making sure that we link them with the Hispanic right, with the Hispanic organizations that are right for that time. And before that, before I have my favorite speaker of today, Nina Vaca, the CEO of Pinnacle, we want to share with you something that we just launched yesterday so that we can share it with you. It is super special for us. We did the premiere, the world premiere, launching the Hispanic Star, the national anthem in Spanish as commissioned by President Roosevelt in 1945. And 75 years of the death anniversary of President Roosevelt, which happened April 12th, we put this together. We revived this version of the national anthem here is Nina Vaca. We're doing this to pay tribute as well to those Hispanics that are on the front line of of the COVID-19 serving this country. So we're going to share with you this video in just a second. As a fact, there you go. Can you hear that? Can you hear something? No sound. We're gonna do this now that we have Nina Vaca here. We're going to go without the video. We're gonna share with all of you the link of the video. But now, Nina Vaca, what a pleasure to have you with us today. Nina, the CEO of Pinnacle Group, a leader, one of the role models, one of the pillars of the Hispanic community. Such a pleasure to have you with us. Nina, it's very, very important to hear from leaders like you in these challenging times, how to take leadership and be able to lead in a time of crisis when everything is adverse. Nina, welcome to the Hispanic Response and Recovery Plan. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you for having me, Claudia. And I saw the video. I want you to know, I got chills. I am so grateful to you. I'm so grateful for your leadership. You have inspired us all to take action. And I want to thank you for that from the bottom of my heart. Thanks for inviting me. Anything, you're absolutely right. This is a time to come together and to be together and to exchange information, exchange stories, ideas, perspectives. And so I'm really grateful that you've invited me here today.
No, no, thank you so very much, Nina. It's because the Hispanics are disproportionately affected by COVID. We need to raise and elevate the issue so that people know how much we're affected at the health level, at the economic level, because we have lost our jobs, our contracts, we're affected because we're working those services that have been affected, but also we're disproportionately exposed because 19 million of our community, 19 million Hispanics still work on essential functions. We are farming to feed America. We are delivering the food, being the truck drivers. We are working in the healthcare industry. So it's very, very important to have an understanding. That's why we launched National Anthem, to have an understanding of how disproportionately this pandemic is affecting Hispanics and how much we have to work together. And to help Hispanics means to help America. Thank you for being with us, Nina. How has COVID-19 affected the Pinnacle Group that you lead? What adjustments have you made? What lessons have you learned in this time? You're an incredible leader. We'd love to learn from you, your lessons learned and your best practices.
Sure. To be quite candid, the last 23 years that we have been in business, everything that has happened to us and everything that hasn't happened to us has prepared us for this very moment. I think that, you know, failure is always brings an incredible gift, and that's the gift of experience. And so we brought a lot of experience to the table, having been around 23 years, having survived 9/11, having survived the 2008 financial collapse. And for us, that has been the best teacher in our past. And so Pinnacle is, I'm proud to say, we're healthy, we are stable, we have a strong balance sheet. Our people's will is very high. We're all rowing in the same direction in our corporate headquarters. We have zero cases of COVID-19. And so this has been an incredible time for our corporate headquarters. We virtualized, one of the biggest changes we've done, Claudia, as you can imagine, is we virtualized the company almost overnight, literally overnight. It turned on like a Christmas tree. And that's because we had been laying the foundation to virtualize the company for many years now. So all the decisions that we've made in the past are coming to roost to prepare us for the present. And so the biggest change we've made, of course, is the virtualization of the company. There are other changes, but we were ready and it's prepared as we could be. 2011 taught us a lot about diversification of our portfolio. Everybody that knows me knows I'm all about financial integrity. I am a zealot about financial integrity, making sure that we're saving, that we're investing in people. That is the oxygen that we breathe as a leader. You take care of your people, and it is critical. That's a critical lesson that we learned in 2001. In 2008, in the middle of the financial collapse in America, we learned about creating business intelligent tools, BI tools, AI tools that allow us to see our leading indicators for our business, not just for our business, but for our customers. 2008, we learned about being nimble, about transforming. And so for us, Pinnacle is not in the survivor mode. We are in the reinvention mode. This is not about survival. This is about reinvention. And so I'm proud to say that we are all rowing in the same direction. It's been my privilege, a privilege to see so many people engaged in the company, all for each other, looking to the right, looking to the left, protecting each other, working for each other. You know, it has been an incredible time in our company. And all I can say is that the will of our entrepreneurial mindset has really flourished and prepared us for today.
And I want to pick up on that, and I commend you. I applaud you as always. You are my role model, my hero. I love you for being who you are, and for being also very communicative about what you're doing, so that people can follow. And this is something that I think. Do you think that before going into the characteristics of leadership that have to be applied today during a time of pandemic, such as communication, is that entrepreneurial mindset that we all Hispanics have? Let's remind ourselves, 86% of every single job in this country since the Great Recession has been created by a Hispanic, because we're that entrepreneur, and Latinas, 50% of that. We create small businesses 6 times faster than any other group, so we're entrepreneurs. Is that an advantage in a time of crisis?
Oh, absolutely. I think that having the mindset of entrepreneurship, having the mindset of transformation is absolutely and unequivocally key. We need to understand that it's not about asking ourselves, how do we get back to what we used to do? It's how do we do what we do in a different world? And those who can make that connection and put their mindset and stop thinking about when can I get back to how things used to be, and understand that the way things used to be is a way of the past. We have to be thinking about transforming ourselves. By the way, in the context of business, just in the context of business, these are not unprecedented times. There are many, many cases. Pinnacle's lived through two of them, but there are many, many cases in the history of business where something changed, something unexpected, and it caused many businesses to go out of business and others to rise and flourish. If you think about the internet, when the internet came out, there were many businesses who went out of business. Those who couldn't transform themselves went out of business. Video stores are out of business. When streaming came along, they couldn't transform themselves. Uber is putting taxis out of business, not because of Uber, but because they will put taxis out of business if they don't transform. So this is all about transformation. And that entrepreneurial mindset, that adaptability, that flexibility that entrepreneurs can bring to the table are key. Let me give you a perfect example. Two, right here in my own home. A mile away from my home, there's a Hispanic restaurant. I drove by on the way to the grocery store. They took shoe polish and wrote on the windows, "Open for business." They have transformed themselves into a delivery company. So they didn't let go of any of their people because they knew they had to transform themselves from a delivery company. My salon studio, where I go to get my hair cut, didn't send me an email. They sent me a text, and the text said, "How can we deliver products and services to your home where you could do it yourself and we could take care of you?" And I was almost shocked to get that from a salon. In fact, I bought stuff just because I wanted to support them, because I could easily go get shampoo at Amazon, but I chose to buy from them because yes. I chose it. I did it intentionally because I said to myself, they are transforming. They have a mindset of change. They want to survive. When you're on the right path, the whole world conspires to help you. And so I think this is a time where entrepreneurship and the mindset of entrepreneurship can be really beneficial.
So I would love to hear whether you agree. I've been slamming and literally just like for the last week saying nothing but Hispanics are disproportionately affected by COVID. But maybe we're disproportionately equipped as well to deal with this because of our mindset, because of our spirit, entrepreneurial mindset, because of our spirit of fighters, because we're optimistic, because we're gonna just keep on going and no tenemos alternativa. So like, I would love to leave a message for people to move from fear to action, to say like, hey, wake up that little entrepreneur that you have in you and start reinventing your business. The way that the salon person sent you a text, the way that the restaurant actually do something in that. So tell us what is the, everybody's going to listen to you. What do you tell them? What do you tell that small business that is freaking out because they don't even know if their parents have COVID and if they're going to survive? That are freaking out because all their contracts have been canceled and they have no idea, you know, like if 50% of Hispanics, Nina, have either in their households have had a pay cut or lost their jobs, 50% of our Hispanics. So what do you tell them? Like, how do we transform this and say, like, we're disproportionately equipped to deal with this. So we just have to plug ourselves into that mindset.
You know what I've learned in life, Claudia, is that inspiration brings by action. There are leaders and then there are those who lead. There are leaders and then there are those who lead. And leaders hold a position of title, influence, and power, but those who lead, they inspire us. Whether it's an organization or an individual, we follow them not because we have to, we follow them because we want to. And we follow those who lead, not because of them, but because of ourselves. Claudia, you inspire me. I follow you because, not because I have to, but because I want to. You see, I am, and I will always be an ambassador to my community. I will always be an advocate of small businesses. Nobody can change that. And nobody, as hard as they try, can take that away. But you inspire me. You fan those flames and you provide opportunity for me to do just that. So we follow those who lead, not for them, but for us. You bring that out in me, and I am grateful. So what I think people need to hear right now is we need to inspire others. The one thing we need more than anything is inspiration. We can either inspire others or find those that inspire us. And that is why I'm so grateful for what you are doing and why I follow you.
Nina, how did you, I mean, like, I do want to talk about the characteristics of the leader that you are, that are so, you know, you taught me bold, courageous, but also communication. How are you communicating with your own group and with others, all the people that follow you, that trust you? You sat down Hispanic leaders and said, you know, like, you sit down, you have to get along, guys. And you also, you have to do this. So how, what is that communication skill set, you know, like that you're using right now? And what other characteristics of a leader do you think that people have to pay attention in these hard times?
Well, the way that I communicate with my own team is incredible transparency and as often as I can. At first, I started communicating with email. And then I said, you know, email is not enough. We did our first global hands-on meeting. We had 4 different continents, a variety of different countries, everybody listening to the same message. Because in the absence of information, people will make things up. And people need to hear from you. They need to hear your mindset because your mindset becomes contagious. And so at Pinnacle, we're now doing Zoom. And by the way, I've had to lean into my own leadership and do things differently. If you know me, you know I'm all about the personal touch. You know I want to be next to you. I want to be, you know, there with you and touch you and be with you and do things together. And that is not available to me right now. So even my own leadership has to transform. And so we did our first global hands-on meeting and we're doing our next one on Monday through Zoom. But I remind people who they are. You know, I lead with transparency. I tell them where we are. I tell them what the opportunities are. I tell them we're stable, we're healthy, but that can change if we're not all rowing in the same direction. Yeah. And so I have found that people want to see that and they want to hear where their work, what the seeds of their labor are. And you have to empathize. I mean, there are many people around the country, certainly in my business, where people are working from their living room floors. They're having to work with small children. They're being teachers, you know, they are double downing on their efforts and they have to be engaged. And so I think my mode of communication has always been with transparency, give them information, give them, just tell them like it is. We have BI tools, so we track all our metrics of our business. We track all our leading indicators. We track them not just of our business, but we track them of our customers. So wherever our customers go, we have no surprises and we make business decisions on those things. So that is how I have chosen to lead. I remind them, you know, Pinnacle has been an award-winning company. We have one of the most streamlined, talented firms. We've got 200 awards and we've got the best management team in the country. I remind them who they are because sometimes we just have to remember who we are. You know, in our last town hall, the line that resonated the most around the company is, we're not going to survive this storm. We are the storm. And so I think people need to remind themselves of what they're capable of and then spur that into action. And for Pinnacle, it has been incredible to watch people lead. Our managers are not communicating, they're leading. And that makes all the difference in the world.
Yeah. And Nina, I think that there's a question also in the chat, which I wanted to ask you as well. When you were talking about you buying from that hairdresser, you're supporting, what, like, beyond the inspiration, we have to take action and we have to take action as Hispanic leaders supporting each other. And I think that the best that we can do for our community is precisely that. It's like, if you're going to hire from each other, if you're going to buy from each other, if you're going to shop from each other. So I think that to this question is, how can leaders help one another exactly? And I wanna add one thing, which is we are thinking that one good thing about COVID-19 is that it's gonna force us or it's gonna bring us stronger together if we unify in this time. If we are united, protecting our community, fighting for our community, putting a plan of recovery for our community and just making sure that we have for September 15, we want to kick off Hispanic Heritage Month, all of us together, in, you know, like regardless of the events that you have for Hispanic Heritage Month, let's do a national conversation with all of us at the local level can gather, do a 100% procured event. So Hispanic food, Hispanic flowers, Hispanic, you know, like music, everything Hispanic to reveal pretty much a national shopping list of Hispanic entrepreneurs and Hispanic small businesses. So here are all the hairdressers, here are all the restaurants, here's all the leaders, here are all the, you know, like the, here's everything, so that we can do a national conversation, virtually connect all of the leaders, but also make sure that the media and everyone else knows that if they want to support us, here is a list of business that you can do. Like, there's no better way to support them just like giving us your, you know, like giving us their choice.
You know, you bring up a very good point, Claudia. And again, the very reason that you inspire us all, because one of the things, in fact, the only thing that you have always led with is unity, is how can we work together to support each other? And that is something that is so critical. And all the events that you're doing, or the conversations that you're having, they're all based around working together. So I think each of us can be doing very different things. We all have a different role to play. If all of us did the same thing, we wouldn't get the same result. And so we each do what we have to offer, what we can give. But I do know that when you're on the right path, the world conspires to help you. And so I have chosen to try to help as much as possible through town halls, through my experience, through advice. I did a town hall with NMSDC. I'm a guest columnist at Latina Style. I'm doing everything I possibly can to help and remember and change the mindset of our community of working together and transforming ourselves. Small businesses can be doing a lot by learning from each other, talking to each other. I find myself calling other women-owned businesses, talking about what they're doing. It is so critical today that we come together and that we exchange ideas, because you never know what will come out of a conversation, what partnership can birth out of that. But all of this to say, the best thing that we could do is be working together.
Yes. And Nina Vaca, I want to thank you so much. You're an inspiration for the entire community. You're a role model for me, a hero and a great friend, always supporting the CEO of Pinnacle, one of the first and only Latinas that is in corporate boards all along, billionaire, an example of what it is to make it. I want to thank you so much for being with us today. Would love to make sure that we connect. We have, in this effort of Hispanic Stars in Action, we have created hubs. Would love to make sure that, you know, like we can activate you being part of a hub, and that we can all of us activate, thinking that it would be possible for a 15th of September activation, bringing all our businesses to light, bringing them visibility, and connecting all of us together. Until then, Nina, I hope that we're going to be connected. And thank you so very, very much for being with us and sharing your lessons for today. Any final word, any way that, you know, people can learn more about what you're doing? Some, you know, like I see you blog constantly. Any final words and a way to connect with you?
I will continue to blog. I'll continue to go. You can go to ninavaca.com or pinnacle1.com and get more information about what we're doing. But do count me. I think this is a time of action. And this is a time, if you can't go outside, go inside. Use this opportunity to transform yourself and be looking forward to the next phase of what you and your leadership will look like. So, Claudia, thank you for having me. Count me as a member of your army, to do what I can, when I can, as much as I can, at the times that I can. And so thank you for bringing us all together. We're all grateful to you.
Absolutely. Nina Vaca, CEO of Pinnacle, today you gave me a great insight, which is we are disproportionately affected, but we're also disproportionately equipped because of that entrepreneurial mindset that we have. We're going to close the webinar now. Michelle Cookwriter, who's on the other line, is going to play the video that we launched yesterday of the national anthem in Spanish to close celebrating the 75th anniversary of the death of President Roosevelt, and to pay tribute to those Hispanics that are in the front lines of the fight of the pandemic, COVID-19. Thank you, Nina. Thank you, everybody. And stay, if you can, to watch this 1-minute video.
Thank you.